You're watching PTS English News. I'm Shen Wupei. Hospitals around Taiwan began giving staff AZ vaccine on March 22nd in light of many reports of side effects associated with AZ vaccines. Premier Su Zhenchang and Health and Welfare Minister Chen Shizhong were the first cabinet member to get vaccinated.
At 7:40 a.m., Premier Su Zhenchang and Health and Welfare Minister Chen Shizhong got the AZ vaccine at National Taiwan University Hospital.
打针的地方并没有任何疼痛的感觉，身体也没有任何酸痛的感觉。那刚才经过30分钟的休息，现在状况良好，
感觉很安心。专家会议的时候，大家也觉得好像近来在欧盟有一些的事件，会不会影响民众对施打疫苗的信心？所以就建议说，应该有一些指标人物，能够出来建立民众的信心。
Taiwan's supply of COVID-19 vaccines has been distributed to 57 hospitals around the island. NTU Hospital got 1,500 vaccines, but only 1,700 of the 8,000 staff surveyed said they were willing to get an AZ vaccine. Central Epidemic Command Center advisor Zhang Shangchun was among the few NTUH personnel that willingly got the vaccine.
疫苗接种咨询小组的一个专家的讨论，确认到目前为止所有的资讯都是认为是没有问题的。国内算是非常非常严谨的去评估这样的疫苗到底适不适合给国人施打。
上礼拜五说，这个礼拜可以接种，我们马上就演练。所以大家可以看出来，我们10位都已经排排坐，坐在这边就已经准备好了。
Zhang says mild side effects reported elsewhere in the world are inevitable, and experts are the ones with the right to decide whether severe side effects are caused by the vaccine or pure coincidence. The Central Epidemic Command Center maintains AZ vaccines are perfectly safe and also says its standards are extremely high.
Meanwhile, experts to comment on whether Premier Su is racing to be the first to take the job will media attention. New Taipei City Mayor Hou Youyi said it shouldn't matter who takes the first shot. And Taipei City Mayor Ko Wen-je responded that he would just pay attention to health issues.
没有，我自己是医疗专业的，所以我不想。我医疗专业还是去处理那医疗专业的，包括那个他现在是用卡片登录嘛，那是给那个。就是病人带回去嘛，不要病人了，就是那个市民带回去。可是这个在，因为这跟那个打流感疫苗不一样，流感疫苗是只有打一次，这个还要打两次嘛，而且中间要隔八个礼拜。
专家学者评估认为施打没有问题，中央跟地方一定共同面对 A G 疫苗的施打，所以新北市在第一个时间也呈报了16家医院。希望16家医院能够同时来施打。
New Taipei City Mayor Hou Youyi also stressed that the central and local government working together to encourage medical professionals and boost their confidence in taking the shot are more important.More than 300 students and teachers at Yuning Elementary School experienced vomiting and diarrhea during the weekend before, so school decided to call Monday off.
On Monday, March 22nd, Yuning Elementary School went through a thorough cleaning and disinfection procedure, cleaning all classrooms, hallways, and corners possible, especially the central kitchen. A couple hundred students and teachers experienced vomiting and diarrhea during the weekend before, and the school decided to call Monday off.
礼拜天的清晨，我们发觉到孩子的身体不适的状况比较多一点，所以我们在昨天下午也透过相关的卫生单位、教育处人员，包含我们县学校端的相关的危机处理小组们，我们大家会议决议，为了让孩子能够有一个最健康的身体来学校学习，那为了让所有家长能够安心。
A large number of families called the school during the weekend to tell them about their children falling ill, and the school made the decision to call school off on Monday to clean and disinfect the school. Yuning County Public Health Bureau reported more than 340 students and 28 teachers feeling unwell. 75 of them sought medical help. The Bureau is looking into the cause.
我们是朝向这个所谓的病毒感染跟的一个简体裁剪跟食物两方面，我们都是同时并行来做这个裁剪。的留作一个简体的一个动作，那今天会再针对厨工的部分，会再做一个简体的一个裁剪。
The cause could be the norovirus or enterovirus, the Bureau said. School lunch from the previous week is currently under inspection.
In the early morning, police stopped a driver and his friends for looking nervous at a checkpoint in Taipei. The driver tried to flee the scene, but they were arrested after police fired 7 shots at the car's tires.
Police ordered the driver to get out of his vehicle. Instead of complying, the driver revs his engine. Police immediately unholster their guns and fire at the car's tires. The driver and his friend are pulled out of the car and thrown to the ground. The suspects were stopped at a police checkpoint on Taipei's Binjiang Street. Police noticed the driver and his passenger looked very nervous and did not make any move to slow down. When approached by police, the driver pretended to turn off his ignition but refused to get out of his car. He then turned the ignition back on and attempted to flee. He was arrested less than 20 meters away after police shot out his tires.
Because 那他同车的后座的友人，这个王姓友人，他有两条法院的这个毒品通缉，可能他身上还有毒品，所以呢，他就铤而走险。
Police found heroin and amphetamines in the car and also discovered there were 2 drug-related warrants out for the passenger's arrest. The two faced charges of possession of drugs, attempting to flee, and resisting arrest.
Now bring you some top stories from around Taiwan. Taiwan started giving AZ vaccines. Taoyuan Hospital was allocated 400 doses, but only 300-plus staff signed up. The vice superintendent of the hospital was the first to get vaccinated. The MOEA says it will start levying a high water usage tax next year. Legislators said the ministry lacks a commitment to go through with it because the tax was passed 5 years ago. Financial Supervisory Commission chair gave a report for troubled by tech firm, formerly International Holding Company. The chair said if formerly failed to issue its report, it would be delisted on April 1st. The head of Taiwan's Mainland Affairs Council, Chiu Tai-san, continues to say that Taiwan is a sovereign, independent country. Chiu also admitted the DPP government has failed at cross-strait relations.
China recently reiterated during talks with the U.S. that Taiwan is an unalienable part of China and called on the U.S. to stop interfering with domestic politics. On the 22nd, Mainland Affairs Council Minister Chiu Tai-san said Taiwan is a sovereign, independent country and not part of the People's Republic of China. Chiu, a proponent of constructive ambiguity, also said he hopes China and Taiwan can find their greatest common denominator and build from there. The PRC's Taiwan Affairs Office immediately shot that down, while admitting the Democratic Progressive Party and Tsai administration have failed at cross-strait relations. Chiu said his current goal is restoring civic exchanges. At the same time, he called on China to stop imposing political frameworks and using military intimidation on Taiwan. With regards to Li Mingzhe, who has served 4 years of his 5-year sentence in China, Chiu said he has been writing letters to his mother and is in good health. As for speculation that Taiwan's relations with Hong Kong and Macau may be irreversible, Chiu said this was Hong Kong's fault alone, but Taiwan will continue dialogue with Hong Kong.
Let's take a look at international news today. Australian authorities are planning to evacuate thousands more people on Monday from flood-affected suburbs in Sydney's west, which is set for its worst flooding in 60 years. Police and protesters clashed in the city of Bristol in southwest England at a demonstration against a government bill that would give police new powers to restrict protests. A Hong Kong pro-democracy activist detained in China this year for illegal border crossing arrived back in the territory and were immediately taken into custody. A According to a report, Japanese Defense Minister mentioned the need to study ways for the Japanese self-defense forces to cooperate with U.S. forces defending Taiwan if needed. Minister of Veterans Affairs Counsel Feng Shiquan said he trusts Taiwan's Ministry of National Defense.
In a fighter pilot jumpsuit, Minister of Veterans Affairs Counsel Feng Shiquan gave his report at the Foreign and National Defense Committee meeting held at the Legislative Yuan on the 22nd. Feng stressed that he would take care of veteran soldiers to the best of his ability. According to Kyodo News from Japan, top U.S. and Japan officials discussed their concerns for a possible military crash in the Taiwan Strait during the U.S.-Japan 2+2 meeting on March 16. Japanese Defense Minister Nobuo Kishi mentioned the need to study ways for the Japanese self-defense forces to cooperate with U.S. forces defending Taiwan in the event of China's aggression. Feng refrained from sharing his personal opinion and only emphasized on trusting Taiwan's Ministry of National Defense.
你们要信任国防部，里面有很多有谋略的啊，这些军官在的。
Although Japan has not given their confirmed response on how they would assist in the case of a crisis between China and Taiwan, both blue and green lawmakers believe that peace and stability has always been the most important aspect in cross-strait relations. They suggest that Taiwan should remain very cautious during the tug-of-war between U.S. and China. No one wishes to see a war happening, and Taiwan should not have to suffer from conflicts being a mere pawn in U.S.-China relations.
两岸的关系毕竟都脱离不了国际的关系，不应该成为啊列强啊彼此啊这个竞争或者是冲突的一个场域啊。相关的安保会谈或者美日二加会谈里面，首先第一次把台湾的议题列为非常优先哦。台湾是日本重要的伙伴以及珍贵的友人，来稳健的发展双方一个互惠互利的合作伙伴关系。
Taiwan's Ministry of Foreign Affairs said that Taiwan would continue to cooperate closely with U.S., Japan, and other countries that share the same values to uphold and defend democracy as the foundation for international order and to maintain regional stability.
Thank you for watching PTS English News. I'm Shen Wu-Pei. See you next time.